ओके फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ नेकलेस एंड वी वेयर एट द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दैट सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ नेकलेस व्हेन मैथिल्ड मेट फॉरेस्टियर. Initially, Forestier did not recognize her due to Mathilde's physical condition. After introduction, Mathilde told her everything about those 10 years and about her suffering. And she told that Forestier had been totally responsible for that. When Forestier asked how should she be responsible at that time, Mathilde told her about that necklace, about missing that necklace and about new necklace which she had given her. When Mathilde told her that she had given other same necklace to her, at that time, look, what did Forestier reply? You say that Madam Forestier was stunned after listening about that new necklace. After listening about that new necklace, Madam Forestier had been totally shocked. Madam Forestier had been totally stunned. You say that you bought a diamond necklace to replace mine. She again confirmed by asking whether she really bought a diamond necklace to replace her given necklace, because she could not believe it. She again confirmed by asking her whether she had really bought a diamond necklace to replace her. Yes, you didn't notice then? Mathilde asked her whether she hadn't noticed at that time. They were very similar. She again told her they both necklace were very similar, so that she would not have found any difference between them. Yes, and look, after listening it, what did she reply? Yes, she smiled with proud and innocent pleasure at that time. Forestier smiled with proud and innocent pleasure. She smiled on that statement. She felt very emotional. Why did she feel emotional? Because Madam Forestier deeply moved, took both her hands. Madam Forestier had been deeply moved. She became so emotional. She took both her hands. Oh, my poor Mathilde, mine was just imitation. Imitation means duplicate necklace. Look, what a tragedy in the life of Mathilde. That necklace was not original necklace, but that was just imitation, duplicate copy of that original necklace. No, it had been not original new necklace. It had been just imitation. And look, for that fake necklace, Mathilde had wasted 10 years of her life in suffering, in struggling. What a tragedy had been in the life of Mathilde. Whose fault was that? Oh, my poor Mathilde, mine was an imitation. It was worth 500 francs at most. Forestier told her that it had been only 500 francs necklace. It had been worth of 500 francs, and Mathilde had given 36,000 francs for that new necklace. Not only money, but she had given her 10 years. She had wasted her 10 years. Not she herself, but her husband. Both suffered too much. Both struggled too much. Look. Then, whose fault was that? Both were same responsible for that misunderstanding. While giving that necklace, Forrester should have informed Mathilde about that necklace, whether it was original or duplicate, original or fake. While taking that necklace, Mathilde should have confirmed about that necklace, whether it had been original or fake. So both were responsible for Mathilde's suffering, Mathilde's tragedy. But I think that instead of Mathilde, Forrester should have told Mathilde everything about Mathilde. She seemed to show her greatness at that time. She seemed to show her richness at that time. So she should have not told that Mathilde. But look, due to just one misunderstanding, how did Mathilde lead her life? Just one misunderstanding caused a lot of sufferings, really. While leading our life, we should be careful about such things. We should clear everything at that same time about anything, so that no any misunderstanding would happen. Really, it had been the great tragedy in the life of Mathilde. In this way, the necklace topic had been completed, both parts I have completed. Now I am just discussing activities in English workshop. You find out the answers of given questions yourself. I am discussing English workshop page number 21. First I discuss activities of second or first part. Everyone pay attention on page number 21. Read each of the following sentences aloud. Write who said it to whom. Who said it to whom? Very simple activity. First, look, here is something for you. Who said to whom? Mathilde's husband to Mathilde. It's very easy. Look, here is something for you. Mathilde's husband to Mathilde. Second, why the dress you go to theater in? Same, Mathilde's husband to Mathilde. Mathilde's husband to Mathilde. I would rather not go to the party. I would rather not go to the party. Mathilde to her husband. Mathilde to her husband. Choose my dear. Madame Forrester to Mathilde. Choose my dear, Madame Forrester to Mathilde. We have nothing else. Mathilde to Forrester. Mathilde to Forrester. Would you lend me this, just this? Would you lend me this, just this? Mathilde to Madame Forrester. Mathilde to Madame Forrester. What? How? That's impossible. Mathilde's husband to Mathilde. It's very easy. Next are question answers. You find out yourself. Now fourth activity I am taking is one invitation, formal invitation. We have to complete as like given in the first part. Very simple. In your unit test or in your exam, such invitations can be asked to complete. Prepare a formal invitation using the following format. Mr. and Mrs. write any surname. You can write your surname. I just take one surname, Mr. and Mrs. Sharma. Solicit the pleasure of your company on the occasion of the wedding ceremony. Take wedding ceremony of their daughter on, take day, Monday, date 20 July 2020, venue, the Star Garden, the Star Garden, near Krishna Temple, Pune. In this way you take proper address, time 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. In this way take time. In this way you have to complete this invitation. Include other requests like RSVP, no present please, etc. at the bottom. You can write no present please at the bottom of the invitation. Very simple. I just read again. Mr. and Mrs. Sharma, solely the pleasure of your company on the occasion of the wedding ceremony of their daughter on Monday, date 20 July 2020, venue, the Star Garden near Krishna Temple, Pune. In this way, time 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. and at the last bottom line, no present please. In this way, you can complete the invitation. Now look about grammar, about determiners. You must have learned determiners. Read the following. The necklace, an error, all these things, another woman, one evening, her husband. All these nouns have been started with some determiners. The necklace, an error, all these things, another woman, one evening, and her husband. In all these phrases, we see some words used before the nouns. If you carefully observed all these words, then in all these phrases, we see some words used before the nouns. They specify or make it clear that what noun we are talking about. Those initial words specify or make it clear what noun we are talking about. These words that are used at the beginning of noun phrase are known as determiners, and these nouns are known as determiners. And these words that are used at the beginning of noun phrase are known as determiners. Look what kind of determiners are there. Have you understood what is determiner? Determiners are such words which are used before the nouns to clear up which noun, to clear what noun we are talking about. And look, there are some kinds of determiners. Determiners include articles, a and the, we have learned. Possessive pronouns, my, our, your, her, his. Demonstrative means this, that, these, those. Demonstrative means this, that, these, those. Quantifiers, much, many, some, few, such quantifiers. Numerals, first, second, third, fourth, fifth. These are the determiners. And with such determiners, nouns are started. Okay? Now write your phrases using each type of reminders. And ice cream, my house, this school, that bridge, many problems, some things, few people, first class, second room, fifth day. In this way, we can use such determiners before nouns. So you should know what are the determiners and which kinds. Okay, and the articles, possessive pronouns, demonstratives, quantifiers, neuters. Okay. Here activities in first part have been completed. Now I am taking activities in second part. Activities in second part. Page number 25. Pay attention here. Page number 25. Complete the following table. It is also same as the first activity in first part. Utterance. Who said it, to whom and when? I touched it in the hall of at the ministry. I touched it in the hall at the ministry. Who said to whom? Matilda to her husband while searching that necklace. When? Who said to whom? Matilda to her husband. Matilda to her husband while searching that necklace. While searching that necklace. It will give us time to look some more. Matilda's husband to Matilda when they could not find that necklace soon. It will give us time to look some more. Matilda's husband to Matilda when they could not find that necklace. I might have needed it. Madame Forestier to Matilda when Matilda gave that necklace to her a bit late. While returning that necklace, you can write in this way, when, while returning that necklace. I might have needed it, Madame Forestier to Matilda, while returning that necklace. You must have made a mistake. You must have made a mistake, Madame Forestier to Matilda. Madame Forestier, Matilda, when Matilda called Forestier at one place after 10 years. When Matilda called Madame Forestier after 10 years. When I lost it, Matilda to Forestier while telling about that necklace. When I lost it, Matilda to Forestier while telling about that necklace. Mine was an imitation. Madame Forestier to Matilda. When she knew about the lost and new necklace. In this way, who said, to whom and when? We completed. Now, page number 26, it's grammar question about verbs. Read, recall, remember. Read the table of verb forms given below. Base form, yes form, past tense, present participle and past participle. V3, we say it, we call it. Give, gives, gave, giving, given. Draw, draws, drew, drawing, drawn. Eat, eats, ate, eating, eaten. Show, shows, showed, showing, shown. Take, takes, took, taking, taken. Say, says, said, saying, said. Come, comes, came, coming, come. Go, goes, went, going, gone, all form of verbs have been explained in this table. Now look in question about these forms below the table. We have learned about infinitive. The base form is you, so that's infinitive. We have just learned about infinitive, and the base form of verbs are you, so that's infinitive. You may go. Go is infinitive. May is auxiliary verb. She will go. Will is auxiliary, and go is infinitive. In orders, go home, and in the simple present tense, we can use in imperative sentence. We use base forms in imperative sentence. Go home. Open your textbooks. Close the windows. In this way, we use base forms in imperative sentence. And also we use in simple present tense. I go to school. We go home. Do you go there every day? The children, they go up. Means in yes no type question, in simple present tense we use base form, and we have learned in tense the structure of simple present tense. Yes plus V1 plus O, it means we use base form of verb in simple present tense. Look again at it. Wherever we use base form of verb, we use in infinitive, we use in command, we use in simple present tense, and we use in yes to that question. Note that, now look, if you have observed the second part of yes form, then look, those verbs have been ended with yes or es. What is the rule behind adding yes or es suffixes? We have learnt in simple present tense. That rule has been explained here. Note that we use yes form with he, she, it means third person singular subjects to show the simple present. If the subject would be third person singular, it means he, she, it. If the subject would be third person singular, he, she, it, then we use yes or es to the verb after those subjects. Now, when to add yes suffix and when to add es suffix? Main, if the main verb is ended with ch, sh, o, x and z. If the main verb is ended with ch, sh, o, x and z, then such main verb should be added with es, otherwise just es. Again tell this rule, if base form of verb is ended with ch, sh, o, x and z, then such main verbs should be added with es, otherwise just es. Its rule we use in simple present. The past tense forms, third column, the past tense form has ed at the end. Generally, past forms of verbs are ended with ed, but many commonly used verbs have different past tense forms. Example, came, went, spoke. Come into came, go into went, speak into spoke, dream into dreamed, see into saw, rise into rose. Such verbs are not ended with ed. They get totally changed. Now, fourth column about present participle. The ing form is known as the present participle. The ing form of the verb means the main verb with ing is known as present participle. It is used with forms of be to show continuous tense. We have learned in tense the ing form of verbs are used in present continuous, past continuous and future continuous. It means such present participles are used with forms of be auxiliary verbs with continuous action. Am is are plus v1 plus ing, present continuous. Was or were plus v1 plus ing, past continuous. Will / shall be plus v1 plus ing is future continuous. It means we use present participle to show continuous tense. For example, I am eating. You were eating. I am eating. You were eating. She was eating. It is also, I am eating, present continuous tense. Eating is present participle. You were eating, past continuous. And she was eating, past continuous. It is also used in certain constructions like he sat copying a manuscript. In some construction we use present participle as like he sat copying a manuscript or he sat thinking deeply. He sat copying manuscript as like he sat thinking deeply. In this way we can use present participle. Now next column, the past participle. We also call it V3. The past participle used with forms of have shows completed action, and everyone knows you have learned in present perfect tense. We use past participle in perfect tense. In present perfect tense, in past perfect tense and in future perfect tense. Have / has plus v3 or had plus v3 or will / shall plus have plus v3. In this way we use in perfect tense. We use past participles in perfect tense. The past participle used with forms of have shows completed action. Examples: I have eaten, present perfect tense. They have come. It is also used in certain constructions. They looked at each other's tunnel. Looked is also looked is past form and tunnel is past participle. In such construction also we use past participle. They looked at each other's tunnel. Now look, again one point, it is also used in passive construction. Everyone have learned active voice and passive voice. We also use past participles in passive voice. Just 1 minute. Kita lagi miss mungkin. Based on these information, some questions have been asked regarding verbs. I just explained you have to do it yourself. Based on these verbs and information, some questions are there. A, B, C, D. 4 questions have been there. I just discussed these questions. Make a table of verb forms of your own reference. Try to arrange the verbs in alphabetical order. Keep adding new verbs to your table from time to time. When you write, check your work to see whether you have used the correct verb forms. It means, as like given table, you have to also form your own table having all kinds of verbs from A to Z, and you have to arrange those verbs in alphabetical order in different forms. It means in yes form, in past form, in present participle, and in past participle. You must have understood this activity. You have to copy out all verbs from A to Z, and we have to arrange them in different forms in alphabetical order. Now B, look, list at least 10 verbs the last letter of which is doubled in present participle. Look, you have to list 10 verbs in which the last letter will be doubled in present participle. There is one rule to have double letter in present participle. I am telling that rule. What is that rule? Look, if before the last letter of the verb there would be consonant, then that last letter would be doubled. If before the last letter of the given verb, if there would be consonant, then the last letter would be doubled. For example, even put putting, before last letter there is U, put putting, so T doubled. In this way you can find out such verbs. For example, cut, cutting, C-U-T-T-I-N-G. Clap, before P there is A, clap, clapping. Before P there is A, clap, clapping. Shut, shutting, S-H-U-T, shut, shutting. Sit, sitting, S-I-T, S-I-T-T-I-N-G. R is consonant there, so double T. Heat, heating, I is consonant, so T is doubled. Rub, U is consonant, rubbing. Chop, chopping. Okay, in this way we can double the last letter if the before the last letter there would be consonant. Now see, list at least 10 words the last letter of which is doubled in the past participle. Now we have to list such 10 words in which last letter would be doubled but in past participle. For example, write, written. Clap, clap, it's also past participle. Skip, skipped, it's also past participle. P is doubled. Then scheme, schemed. Then look, such examples. Knit, knitted, double T is there. Chop, chopped. In this way, in past participle also, for some words we take double letter. Okay, you find out. Now D, list at least 10 words the last letter of which is doubled in past tense form. Now we have to list such 10 words. In such 10 words, the last letter would be doubled. Green, green, G-R-I-N, G-R-I-N-N-E-D, green. Chop, chopped, pin, P-I-N, pinned. Clip, clipped. Then clap, clapped, rob, robbed. Such verbs can be example of having double letters in past form. In this way, here all activities have been discussed. Now I am not starting a new lesson. Just I am discussing some questions. Whatever possible I discuss, the remaining should be done by yourself. I have discussed all activities. Whatever activities have been discussed, you have to copy out in your notebooks, and especially activities of verbs should be copied in your notebooks. Those four questions should be copied in your notebooks by yourself. Okay, now let's take some questions. Page number 18. First question: why was Mathilde married to a minor official? We have to reason of this question. Look, Mathilde was born into a family of clerks. They were from middle class family. Mathilde was born into a family of clerks. They were from the middle class family. Due to their economic condition, there was no any way of becoming known and also understood by others. So Mathilde was married to a minor official. In this way you can answer. The most important point is about her financial condition. Mathilde was born into a family of clerks. Mathilde was from middle class family. Due to her economic condition, there was no any way of becoming known and also for understood, and so she was married to a minor official. Now next question: why did Mathilde weep with misery after visiting her schoolmate? Mathilde was from middle class family, but she would always dream of luxurious lifestyle. She would always expect of high class life, and her schoolmate, her former schoolmate, was very rich and living a luxurious lifestyle. So Mathilde wept with misery after visiting her schoolmate. In this way you can answer. Look, again I tell answer of this question. Mathilde was from middle class family, but she would always dream of a luxurious lifestyle. She would think of high class life, and her former schoolmate was very rich. She was living luxurious lifestyle. So Mathilde wept with misery after visiting her schoolmate. Now next question: what did the envelope hold? Look, what did that envelope hold? The envelope held an invitation. The envelope held an invitation for Mathilde and her husband by the Minister of Education and Madame George Rampuneau to attend one ceremony at the ministry on the evening of Monday, January 18th. Once again, I answer of this question. The envelope held an invitation for Mathilde and her husband by the Minister of Education and Madame George Rampoux to attend one function, one ceremony at the ministry on 18th January or on Monday 18th January. Full stop. In this way, you can answer of this question. Now, page number 19. Next question, it's personal response question. You have to give your opinion. Was the husband a considerate person, means kindful person? How do we know that? Yes, due to her behavior we have known it. Yes, the husband was a considerate person because he always tries to fulfill the demands of his wife Mathilde. We have looked by one example. He sacrificed his own need to buy a nice dress for Mathilde, although they were from middle class family. Mathilde's husband tried to fulfill her demands and satisfy her. By this behavior we can say that the husband was a considerate means kindful person. Again, first answer, yes, the husband was a considerate person. How do we know that? We know that from his behavior. Although they were from middle class family, Mathilde's husband tries to fulfill her demands, and we came to know it by one example in this lesson. Mathilde needed a nice dress to wear in party. At that time, Mathilde's husband managed to give her money by sacrificing his own need. By this thing we came to know it that husband was a considerate person. Now, next question. Why did Mathilde go her friend's house and tell her of her distress? Look, its answer. Why did Mathilde go her friend's house and tell her of her distress? Mathilde had been invited to attend one ceremony at the ministry, but she did not have rich jewels. She did not have rich jewels to wear in that party, and she could not. She was not ready to attend that party without jewelry. So Mathilde went to her friend's house and told her of her distress. Once again I tell, Mathilde and her husband had been invited to attend a ceremony at the ministry, but unfortunately Mathilde did not have rich jewels to wear in that party, and she was not ready to attend that party without nice and rich jewels, and it was not affordable to buy such jewelry for them. So Mathilde went her friend's house and told her of her distress. Okay, in this way you can answer of this question. Remaining questions should be done by yourself. There are many questions and All questions are very easy. You can find out the answers from this lesson, and you can give your opinion for personal type questions. Okay, I stop here. We shall take next lecture in next lesson in next lecture. Okay.